sometimes and rain sometimes.
Well, will you stop asking me all these questions? You're driving me crazy with all these questions.
But wait a minute. Questions are very important.
Right.
They are.
I know. You tell them why, won't you?
Who, what, where, when, why, how? What do you want to know now?
Right.
Who, what, where, when, why, how? What do you want to know now?
See, I told you. Questions are important.
Well.
Why ask a question to get an answer? That's what a question is for.
See?
When you ask a question, and how old are you?
Let me see.
What is the time of day?
That's a good one.
And when is your dog's birthday?
Oh, I know this one.
Where do potatoes grow? And who says ho, ho, ho?
Anybody
know that? Oh, I ask a question to get an answer. That's what a question is for. When you ask a question, you'll get an answer. That is the way you learn more. Tell me why. Why are your eyes blue?
Because my dad's are.
And how old are you?
7. I'm a saint.
What is the time of day?
About 4 o'clock.
And when's your dog's birthday?
Yesterday.
Good answer. Where do potatoes grow?
In the ground.
And who says ho, ho, ho?
Everybody knows Santa Claus.
Yeah. Who, what, where, when, why, how? What do you want to know now?
Who, what, where, when, why, how? What do you want to know now?
Be proud to ask. It's good to know. That's the way we grow.
Hey, do you all know who this person is here?
Yeah.
You do? What's her name?
Sally Rock.
Yeah, boy.
What's she do?
She's an astronaut.
An astronaut.
That's right. It's a pretty big word. What's that?
It's a person who goes up to space and tests and launches satellites for TV and everything like that.
Yeah.
Would you all like to go up in space sometime?
Yep.
Yeah.
What do you think it'd be like?
Fun.
Fun?
What's the fun part?
Flying up and down.
I think so, too. What kind of stuff did you do once you got up there?
We did a lot of different things. We carried a couple satellites up into space, and we released them, put them up, we carried them up in the shuttle, and then we took them out of the shuttle and left them on their own up in space. They're still up there now. We ran a lot of experiments. We had one experiment to make medicines that you can't make down here on Earth.
You know, that's really going way, 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 way up in the sky. You know how high that is going up there?
Yeah.
How high do you think it is?
How high do you think it is?
Is a building?
100 feet?
No.
5 billion feet, something like that.
5 billion feet.
You know,
to figure that one out.
Wouldn't it be higher than the tallest building, and even going higher than a plane, and
that's
higher
right.
than any
that's right.
cloud?
In fact, you know, when we launch, we go straight up in the air, and it takes us about 8 minutes to get where we're going, and after 2 minutes, we're already much higher than any airplane. So in about the time I can count to 20, we're almost as high as the clouds.
How does it feel when you're up there?
It's fun. It's, you know what weightlessness is?
Yeah. No.
So when we get up there, we're weightless, which means that we can float. We're not pulled down to the ground like you and I are being pulled down to the stairs.
Yeah.
Okay, we've got weight. Well, up in space, we're weightless. We would just float right up off the stairs. I could take a ball and just let it go right here, and it wouldn't fall. It would just stay right where I put it.
Does it feel like a balloon?
Feels a little bit like a balloon. It feels a little bit like when you're in the water and you're held up. It's fun moving around and pushing off the walls and eating lunch on the ceiling. It doesn't feel like anything that you can experience here on Earth.
Is your space suit comfortable?
Sure is. You know what else we wear? We wear this for launch when we're first going up, and then re-entry and landing when we come down. And some of the rest of the time, in pictures that you might have seen, we're just wearing regular t-shirts and sometimes shorts when we exercise.
Is how did you exercise if you didn't weigh anything?
Well, that's...
How could you tell if you were doing
that's
it?
That's a good question, because you really don't use your muscles at all up there. It's so easy to move around. You can just push off a wall, and you float across the room. So you don't use your muscles much. We had a treadmill that we carried that we had to strap ourselves down to, so we were being pulled down onto the treadmill. And then we could run on it and exercise our legs that way.
How do you eat?
Well, we carry up a lot of food that's a lot like camping food. Some of it is just packages of peanuts and candy, M&Ms, that kind of thing, that you can just open and eat. And some of it is dehydrated. They've sucked all the water out of it, and we've got to put the water back in. And we carry vegetables and steak and
chicken. So how do you eat it? Doesn't it float up in the air?
You wouldn't want to have peas or anything like that, because if you opened up a can of peas, they'd all
peas and steak.
But mashed potatoes are good. Mashed potatoes stick right to the can. And you can set the tray right in front of you and just leave it there and then take a spoon and eat it. We've got spoons that we use.
Oh, so if you took the food on the spoon, it wouldn't float off the spoon.
Most of it sticks to the spoon. It's got to be kind of sticky food.
Could you see New York from the satellite, from the space shuttle?
Uh-huh. It's possible to see New York. We don't go quite high enough in the space shuttle to see the whole Earth. You might have seen pictures of the Earth that just looks like a big ball. We don't get quite that high, but we can see all of the United States just looking out in front of us. And it looks, you can see all the colors. You can see blues in the ocean and greens and reds on the ground. It's really pretty.
And I sure would like to go up in space. How about you, Bob?
I would. How many here would like to go up in space with Sally on the next ride? You're going to go up again?
I'm going up again.
You'd like to do it again, right?
I would like very much
Listen,
to do it again.
No problem if we all go up with you, is it?
No, it's no problem.
You can arrange that?
Sure, you can all come.
How about all going up in space with Sally the next time? How many want to do that? Okay, you got a deal. It's okay if we all go, right?
Sure, no problem.
Okay, good.
Oh, boy. Hi, Big Bird.
Ah, hi, Susan. Say, looks like you've been doing some shopping there.
Oh, I have. Some very special shopping. I picked up things for Gordon's favorite meal. I'm going to cook for him while he relaxes. Bought him some flowers. Aren't they pretty?
Oh, those are nice.
He really likes flowers. Then after dinner, I'm taking him to a movie. He'll really be surprised.
Well, that sounds great. You have a good time, Susan.
Okay. First, I'm going to sit here and rest, though. Ooh, what a day.
Hi, Big Bird.
Hi, Gordon. How are you?
Fine. Say, look at these. Aren't they pretty?
Yeah.
I got them as a surprise for Susan. She loves flowers. And I also did some special shopping on the way home from work. I bought some of her favorite things for dinner. I'm going to do all the cooking tonight. And, you know, she'll just take it easy. Then after dinner, I'm going to take her to see a movie.
Oh.
Huh? Nice surprise, huh?
Yeah, sure is. Well, good luck.
Okay, see ya.
Oh, boy. You see that? Well, maybe we better watch and see how grown-ups work their way out of this problem.
Hello there!
Hi, honey! Surprise! They're the same flower.
Exactly.
That guy down the street didn't tell me.
No, me either. Well, these are yours.
Those are yours, and these are mine. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Sir.
And I also did some special shopping, picked up some of your favorite things for dinner. I don't believe this.
Oh, dear.
You.
Yes.
That's
well, cool. Anyway, we can.
Okay, we'll put your things in the freezer. We'll put some of your things in the freezer and some of my things in the freezer.
Okay.
But I'll do the cooking tonight.
No, honey. You see, my surprise was that I'm going to do the cooking.
But that was part of my surprise to you.
Let's both do the cooking. It'll be much faster because after dinner, I'm taking you to the movies. I want to support you up, kid. Take you to the movies.
I don't believe this. I was going to take you to the movies after dinner.
You were going to?
That's right. Do you believe this?
Well, listen, what I think we ought to do is
just stay home and relax. Mm-hmm. Good idea. Okay.
Boy, oh boy.
This isn't fair.
Gordon, who's gonna do the dishes?
I'm not
getting
that look. No, we went through this.
Hi, guys.
Oh, hi, Maria.
Maria, how would you like to come to dinner? Yeah, we got some really nice food.
Yeah,
here
you'll really
tonight.
Like it.
And yeah, come on, really.
Come right on in.
You'll love it.
Gee, that worked out much neater than I ever expected. Oh, hi. Guess what? I got these things out of my trunk because I thought of a terrific game to play. It's about body parts, and it's all about... Whoosh.
Game, yes. Game.
Ah, so you want to play my game, too, huh,
yes,
Elmo?
Yes, play.
Okay, well, why not? Now, here's how it works, Elmo.
Yes.
See, look, here's my galoshes.
Yes, galoshes.
Yes?
Yes.
Okay, and
galoshes.
Here's
yes.
my hat.
Oh, hat.
And here's my scarf.
Oh, scarf.
Okay.
Scarf.
Now,
yes.
here's how the game works.
Yes.
You put them on, and we'll see if you put the right body part in each thing. Do you understand?
Yes. Yes, I start.
Okay.
Yes.
Go right ahead.
Yes, I start.
Do you know which body part goes in which thing? Well, I'll help you remember. And then we'll see if Elmo gets it right. Now, the galoshes go on the feet. See? One goes on this foot, and the other goes on this foot. And then, of course, the scarf goes around the neck, and then finally, the hat goes on the head. Now, let's see how Elmo is doing. Elmo?
Yes.
Elmo, where are you?
Here. Good game. Thank you. Bye-bye.
But... Well, I guess I'll put these things back in my trunk. Oh, hi, Snuffy.
Oh, hello, Bert. Oh, my goodness, Bert. You have there your winter hat and your warm scarf. And your galoshes.
That's right.
Oh, Bert. Oh, dear. I am very angry with you, Bert.
You're angry with me? But why?
Because you went to the North Pole without me, Bert. You know we always planned on going together. Oh, I am very disappointed.
But wait. Don't go, Snuffy. I haven't been to the North Pole.
Oh, you haven't? Well, then why do you have all your winter clothing out here like this?
Well, I was just showing the kids something. I wouldn't go to the North Pole without you, Snuff. Why, we've always planned to go together.
Oh, thanks for saying so, Bert. I'm sorry I got mad with you. I should have asked you first.
Well... That's quite okay, old Snuff, old pal.
Oh.
I understand. Well, now that you're here, what would you like to do?
Oh, Bert, I have a good idea for a game we could play.
What?
Well, you put on your hat and your scarf and your galoshes, and we'll see if you got them on the right body part. Okay, Bert? Okay, Bert?
Yeah, sure, Snuff. And then we'll go to the North Pole.
Oh, good.
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters W and X, and by the number 3. Thank you. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.